स्वागत है आपका शॉर्ट हैंडियंस गॉट इट चैनल पर। वीडियोस अगर पसंद आ जाएं तो लाइक शेयर और सब्सक्राइब कर दीजिएगा। लेटेस्ट डिक्टेशन और जॉब नोटिफिकेशंस को पाने के लिए बेल आइकन प्रेस कर दीजिएगा ताकि आपको टाइम पे आपकी डिक्टेशंस मिल सकें। थैंक यू सो मच।
स्टार्ट द स्ट्रेंथनिंग एंड इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ 14 इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजिकल इंस्टीट्यूशंस सिचुएटेड इन डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री हैज बीन सैंक्शनड एंड इज नाउ इन द थर्ड ईयर ऑफ इट्स ऑपरेशन। दिस स्कीम विल कॉस्ट अप्रॉक्सीमेटली रुपीज 1.5 करोड़। The government have also sanctioned large amount for the development of the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Now that the Indian Institute of Technology has been established, fresh encouragement will be given to the improvement of technical education throughout the country. The institute will provide postgraduate and research facilities which can be utilized properly only if a sufficient number of graduates in engineering and technology of a sufficiently high quality are forthcoming to take advantage to the facilities offered. This aspect of the question is constantly in our minds, and I can assure you that the government will continue to take a deep interest in the all-round development of facilities of technical education throughout the country. The institute which is being inaugurated today will have provision for the teaching of 2000 students at the undergraduate level and 1000 students for postgraduate study and research. These students will be drawn from all over the country and their close association in a fellowship of study and research in some of the most formative years of their life will, we earnestly hope, develop in them a consciousness of their common Indian nationality and culture. The institute's main function is no doubt to provide facilities for training high-grade engineers and technologists, but facilities for research as well. Mr. Vice Chairman, sir, I rise to support the 6th schedule to the Constitution Bill 1988, which is brought on the floor of this House. Sir, it is a welcome measure in the right direction. This bill seeks to devolve more powers to the district councils. Sir, in the district councils, the members are the tribals. Sir, the founding fathers of the Constitution of India, through their wisdom and political foresight, recognized the very delicate sentiments, culture, and traditions of the tribals. They foresaw that unless certain protections are given to the tribals in the management of their affairs, they will be submerged in the process of normalization along with the most or more advanced people of the plains. This aspect was recognized not only by the founding fathers of the Constitution but by the alien rulers as well. According to 1937 Act, certain areas of Assam in the northeastern region were kept excluded to be looked after by the governor. This was also a recognition to the very peculiar feature prevailing in the tribal area. This was intended to protect the innocent tribals from being exploited by more advanced people of the plains. So, when the constitution was drafted, this special provision was made to protect the interests of the tribals, particularly in the northeastern region. Sir, even before the drafting of the Constitution of India, the tribal in the northeastern region agitated, and they showed their resentment that when the British leave the country, they should be kept in such a way that their culture and their tradition are safeguarded. When the subcommittee of the Constituent Assembly, in which Brother Basu was also a member, when they visited, stop, over.